ready to hear some jazz? Jersey, so sometimes I forget. Are y'all ready to hear some jazz? Yeah!
Thank you.
once in a while, we get a famous tune that enters the public domain, which means you can actually arrange it and sell it as your own. And this one is going to enter the public domain in 2024, so I'm getting a head start. So what we're going to do is, the band is actually going to record it, we're going to do these recordings, and that'll be a headliner for the arrangement. So thank you, band, appreciate it. But I also really love this tune, because I kind of grew up with it in a weird way. A lot of us have heard this tune throughout time, and if you're a little older, you might know the Irving Berlin version, which was, if you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where Harlem fits, putting on the Ritz. But then, of course, the words got changed over time, and it got to be, if you're blue, you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where fashion sits, putting on the Ritz. And so the words have changed over time, but the melody has always been very catchy and fun. A lot of you might know this from 1974, when it was featured in the Mel Brooks movie, Young Frankenstein. A couple of Mel Brooks fans out there, okay. I actually grew up in the, I'm not gonna say that. But in the early 80s, there was a Dutch musician named Taco. Anybody remember Taco?
Yeah.
Okay, one or two people. And Taco did a synth pop version of this song, and it actually went on all the top 40 charts all over America and all over the world. And that's where I actually first learned this song, and I was always very intrigued with the melody. And so when it came into, it's about to come into public domain, and it got to a point where I could arrange it, I knew it would be great for jazz band, and I knew it would be great for this band. So when I arranged this piece, I really arranged it customized for these students. This is Putting on the Ritz.
Thank you.
own session.
Thank you.
where they were playing at a venue, and it got raided by the police, and Thelonious Monk declined to show his ID to the police, and so they start to thrash him. And Bud Powell ran into his defense and said, "No, don't do that. That's the best pianist in the world. Don't hurt him." And so Bud Powell was nearly smashed over the head with a police baton and taken to the hospital, where he got abandoned and then thrown into jail with Thelonious Monk. And that's how the story goes. And so, as an homage to his friend, Bud Powell, he wrote a song called In Walked Bud. And about 20 years later, they put some words to it. And the words were Dizzy's screaming, OP's beaming, Monk is thumbing, and suddenly In Walked Bud, and they got up to something. This is In Walked Bud.
Thank you.
so I know we got lots of famous people in the audience tonight. I know we got my good friend and choir director at Midwestern State University, Dr. Thomas Weiniger, in the audience. Thank you very much for playing. You guys have done fantastic.